Like I said yesterday, mounting the throttles on the plate and going to check it on the car. Now, throttles plugged in. Adaptation of the idle position of the throttle valve actuator was not performed. This is stalled. I'm clearing the fault. The intake manifold pressure sensor, obviously it's not being connected. Internal data could not be stored in the control unit. This is... Sorry, I have no clue what's that. I worry about these two faults. That these faults, when I finish, will disappear completely. Obviously, also the intake manifold pressure sensor, the map. Let's continue. Screw it. I plug also the map sensor down over there. So, coming here. No fault. Let's make one actuation test for the throttles. Give me a second. No fault, just let's go inside of the car and see if we're gonna follow. How gas in other throttles. See, when you're alone here, I can hear the throttles, I cannot see the throttles. Let's see how I'm gonna put it to have a look on it. This way better, maybe. It's better to stay like this. Or bring it from this side. Yeah, I think I'll be able to see that. The important thing is to close back the throttles, not to... They're opening. And when I make ignition off, there you go. Yes. This movement, what I want to see, when you make ignition on, that it can make this movement. Now it returned back again in place. And now you see again if there is any fault. And there is no fault. So I can continue closing the intake manifold. This is one small test of what I'm doing all the time before I close the throttles, before I put them back, to don't have any headache. Because if there is one in a million problem with one of the throttles, you have to open again the intake manifold. Continue. At this point, don't forget something. This one and this one, I'm not putting it back. Why I'm not putting it back? This is like a sponge. If you make it wet, this one, and then you try to squeeze it, you'll gonna see that's holding so much water on it. So inside of them. So I'm not putting it back, because usually the most corrosion is happening where it's stepping these two pads. So this is going back to the customer in a nylon bag. And if you want my opinion, this is good only to collect humidity or water. These two pieces. These are the pieces that are going in the valley. One comes front over there, like this, and the other one goes back over there. Sorry, I'm canceling it. And now came the time to put it back in place. New gaskets. New PCV. Ready to go. Alright, let's start it. Clear the faults. Yeah, it's ready to start. Yep, yep, yep. 1 second. Not bad. There is no cold start. Most probably they turn off the cold start. Probably. Let's see all the diagnostic I have over there. It's charging. That's why I have it here. Let's go back one step back. It is already on. Here you can see the battery voltage. By the way, they changed also the battery, the guys. Yeah, come on. All right. Not bad, not bad. Nice. It is a cold start, by the way, yeah. And that's it with this one. I didn't tie this because I have to put the rubber down. I don't know where they put the guys. I didn't find it. And when they come, they have to start it, warm it up to check also the oil level. So that's it. Finished with this car. Let's continue now with this intake manifold. And wish me luck to see what kind of title I put for this car. Did I start a video on this car? I don't remember, honestly. I have no clue. Okay, I'm gonna have a look on it. That's it. That's it. That's it with this one. Thank you.